In August 2021, in the midst of the COVID pandemic and the layered and complex challenges of the 21st century, a valiant, if somewhat foolhardy, group of students, staff, and faculty set off on a grand adventure on the Mississippi River. They gathered at the headwaters at Lake Itasca. Zoe and Nell and Kelly and Sarah, Megan, Dylan, MJ and Helica, Niall, Elias, and Emily, and then later, Stephen and Hannah.
They set off down the headwaters, first walking along out of Lake Itasca, wondering what would happen to the river, to the water that was flowing out there, what it would see, what they would see over the next 100 days, which is about as long as it would take that water to reach the Gulf of Mexico. Got a little time in canoes, paddling on the lake there, getting a feel for what it was like to move over the water in that way, getting to know each other for the first time. We started to build community through some wackiness, some goofy exercises in the morning, and by adopting the personas of Life Aquatic, inspired by Wes Anderson's film of that name, that Emily decided would be part of the motif of our trip this year. So we got the red hats, and we started singing and dancing and doing some general goofing around here at the farm in Wabasha, doing some more dancing in the barn that night.
And this year we had three alumni from the trip, the dream team, our field guides, Hannah, Nell, and Stephen.
We had some amazing food, including a lot of fresh pasta and all sorts of other gourmet food that we had along the way, using some of the amazing talents of our team. Lots of fresh food, lots of carbs, lots of yummy sauces.
And they would literally go to any length and climb to new heights to help us with all sorts of tasks and just be a vital part of the team, what we called Team Gumption.
Yes!
We camped all along the way in some beautiful spots, sometimes with some lovely weather, like this rainbow we had over our camp at Hoxala. And we had all sorts of sunrises, sunsets, lots of beautiful sky, misty mornings with these funny new boats. And we set up the latrine every night. In the midst of all this, we had to fit in classes sometimes with guest lectures like Natalie Warren and her guitar, Joe with his whiteboard and computer, learning about Dakota histories and epistemologies and resistance, about climate change and capitalism, about new forms of political action and grassroots work, about river politics and the complexities of life in the Anthropocene. And studying and work took place on beaches, going to public library, and sometimes having class on the boats when we were sailing along. Fall 2021 was generally pretty good for weather, but we did get some cold, rainy days like this stay we had in Greenville, Mississippi. But that didn't stop Kelly and others from getting work done, registering for classes, and we would still have to cook our meals and take care of everything there, even when the cold rain was falling. And then drying out at camp once the sun came back. Traveling in this slow, intimate way along the river allowed us to see firsthand what some of the effects of human activities have been along the river, from the pipelines up north to in various industrial facilities like those that we saw as we paddled and sailed along Beaver Slough here, a little north of the Quad Cities, where There are a number of big factories called wet mills that make all sorts of products out of corn and soybeans. They make sugar and starch and animal feed and alcohol and plastic. And we could see immediately the impacts with some of the outflow pipes coming right into the river there as we pass by. And here's another one. And it was quite a stark reminder of the impact. And at another location here, a little further south near Baton Rouge, the effluent from a toilet paper manufacturing facility run by Georgia Pacific. But sometimes the water there apparently is just all black. Despite the pandemic, we still had a chance to meet with all sorts of good folks doing work and resistance and rebuilding along the river. Mussel Propagation Center near Lake City. Our friend Ben Weaver here, who sang and told the stories to Fritz Funk, who came out and visited with us. And the Armacosts, who were paddling the whole river and each night played taps in honor of those who had lost their lives to COVID. And we were so fortunate to have my good friend Mike Strong come along and teach us sailing and yoga. And Chris Fink from Beloit College, who came and helped us out and shared with us some of his creative writing and poetry. Made a podcast about his time with us and helped us load the boats. And Emily just couldn't stay away. And after being gone for a month or so, came back and finished out the trip with us and helped out with all sorts of projects along the way. And in Helena, Arkansas, we were joined by a wonderful river rat and my good friend John Ruskey, who came with us for a day and shared some of his wisdom and knowledge about the river, got to travel along in the water striders, and he was a little puzzled that we didn't have to paddle because that's how he's used to traveling. But he got used to it, and we were pleased he had a red hat because he fit right in. And speaking of red hats, the mythic Steve Zissou even showed up to share some of his wisdom from his many years at sea. And once we had some non-human visitors who came along, including this silver carp who jumped into the boat, and we decided to let him go. Along the river, we experienced the generosity of river angels and got to meet and listen to wonderful guides like the very knowledgeable and entertaining Barney and Shabila in Natchez, who showed us all around town. And at the LSU Center for River Studies, where our guide there showed us this bizarre model of the lower Mississippi River. But through it all, one of the greatest pleasures was just getting to know the river, spending time on the river, on these boats, paddling off the first day here from Watergate Marina after the christening. And the boat's all fresh and new, and the students all fresh and new, and just kind of getting the feel for it as we went along. And we headed south. Under the High Bridge at St. Paul, under a lot of other bridges as we went along, some that they had to lift for us, others that we easily fit under. Here on our first day, heading out of St. Paul with Marin at the helm.
We're leaving St. Paul.
And being able to sail was just an amazing treat and all. Made the whole experience so much more relaxing in a way, gave us time to just be together on the water, to walk, look around, to talk, to study, to read, and to learn how to sail, which was new to almost everyone on the trip. So that was a lot of learning there. And sometimes even got to do a little swimming from the boats.
I was walking home, broken. Hello. I was walking home, broken. I was walking home, broken.
And a big part of our time on the water was our encounters with these barges, which were a huge presence on the river. And we had to talk to them on the radio a lot. And sometimes we'd listen in to what they were saying to each other. It was kind of fun to get used to that language.
Yeah, well, I want to get on that dike up there, this wind and all that. All right, we be standing by, okay?
Hey, Jack, lay on the outside of you or something.
I'll get my relief base post pilot. He should be able to get up there on the trail dike or up there across from Horner Field. I know it takes up there, but there should be enough room for two. Or he can get up there to the trail dike anyways. But no, I'll leave that spot for you. We'll find somewhere.
Alright, I sure appreciate it. Where's Worthy shut down at now?
Austin's coming back.
He ain't coming back until Tuesday. I got 72 days in. I'm ready.
72? Yeah, he's ready.
Some post pilot. I can't think of his name.
Alright, take care.
Sir, you do the same.
And so, as we got closer to the end of the trip and the students had gotten really comfortable with being on the boats and good at sailing and boat handling and all the different skills needed, communicating and reading the charts and working together as a team, keeping each other's spirits up, they took over running the trip. So for the last 3 days sailing down to Baton Rouge, it was their journey, their adventure. And they rose to the challenge and did amazingly well. And that included some tricky passages, going around some tight bends, barges coming, and having to work together and share knowledge and paddle, and steer, and read the wind, read the water. And it was exciting and empowering. It was challenging, sometimes frightening. But all in all, an educational, fun time. At each of our seats, we carried our gear and our stuff. Things we needed. Things we could leave behind sometimes. Each our own little packet of goods. Needed to pass the time, to communicate, to keep ourselves safe and dry. At the end of the day, all these different lines, all these different strands wove together into a wonderfully integrated experience, the kind you can only get when you're out in the field. By the time we got to Baton Rouge, we decided that was a good place to wrap it up.
Helica, what do you think? Final thoughts, here we are.
I don't want to think about it.
Okay. Kelly, how you feeling?
It's crazy! Okay. This is dope.
Stella, what's the word? We made it.
Made it.
Just loving understanding. Megan, how's it feel?
Feels really good.
How do you feel? We just finished 83 days on the river, made it to Baton Rouge.
I feel accomplished.
There you go. Nice.
Lots of matches. Treated you. Lots of meander. Mm-hmm. Lots of moments.
What's your thoughts?
Any words? Yay!
Did it?
We did it! I can't believe it. It was a little scary this morning.
I was very stressed, but very worth it. Very worth it, yes.
MJ, how you feeling?
Woo!
Alright. Let's see. Niall, any words for the camera? How you feeling?
So good.
All right.
Really happy. Tired but happy.
Alright.
I'm so proud of all the students. They did an amazing job navigating all the traffic coming into Baton Rouge and feeling just so proud of them.
Yeah. Alright.
And then it was on to New Orleans, to the Big Easy, to see some of the sights, to relax a little bit, go to some wonderful art at Studio B and hear from some more artist activists like Judith here, and just explore some of the delta there, a lot of oil company property, and abandoned dreams and making it down to Mardi Gras Pass, which is about as far south as we got to this new opening in the river that the river has cut in the levees there. And then at last we made it to the Gulf of Mexico, driving down to Sycamore Point, Cajun country there, in this misty, misty Gulf air so full of water that there were mist bows. In some of our last mornings at camp, where we'd been getting so used to living outdoors and spending this time together, this was on our 100th day, which also happened to be the birthday for Sarah and Hannah. So we had a little time to celebrate there on the beach.
How's it going, guys?
Good morning!
And on that day, we did our last water blessing. This was a ceremony we had done just about every week as we went along. And this time, we had delivered our water from the headwaters. We carried it all the way along and then refilled this jar with water from the Gulf, which we will take care of and pass along to the next group of River Semester students for their journey. As I think back on this trip, and it's been a wonderful trip, and it's been so nice having this time with you all, I think about the importance of just really trying to live differently, to live otherwise, as what we've talked about. I continue to just feel that the world we're living in is on the wrong track in so many ways, and that there's different ways to be teaching and learning, different ways to be living, traveling, and that there's a lot of promise in this idea of living intensely, using our bodies, being physically engaged with the world, connected with the world, living in a strong community, living simply, facing difficult realities, and making the best of them, knowing that we may not be able to fix all the problems in the world, but we can do a little bit, do what we can, and that there's a lot of joy in that. There's a lot of fun. There's something incredibly satisfying about being on these challenges together and exploring the world. So I hope that you all have more opportunities to do some of that, to explore what it means for each of you to live differently, to live meaningfully, to live richly and fully in the world on your journeys ahead. It's been great. And as you head out into the world from this trip, I wish you bon voyage.
Okay.
Oh my god, just the voices. Just the voices.